This is a 1972 Yamaha U7e. It's actually pretty unique. I know some of you might not like tiddlers, so boy, it's noisy here. Sorry about that. Some of you might not like tiddlers, and if that, you can just move on, wait for another episode. But this bike is actually pretty unique. It was offered in America 1 year only. That doesn't really make it more valuable, but it makes it different. They made a U7, which I don't think was offered here either. They made a U50, which was a 50cc version, and the U7e gave you electric start. It's aimed directly at its competitor right there, the Honda 50 Supercub. But I think this, being a two-stroke, it's actually more bike. You'd think that'd be more primitive, but they made this one civilized. Electric start, 12 volt. That one takes an odd 6 volt battery. Takes a lot of amps to power that electric starter. This takes a more conventional 12 volt that you can actually get. Oil injected, so you don't have premix. You got the mouse trap. They tried to copy that on a two-stroke platform, but make it more civilized. They're both three-speed automatic clutch. The book says that's about 4.5 horsepower, and this is 5 horsepower. But this feels significantly more zippy than that. In fact, after riding this, I don't really like that.
Oh, I bought this bike maybe 6 years ago. Off and on, I've got it going. It was sitting on the shelf for a while. It's pretty much how I got it. Came with books, an old Midwest title, I think it was from Indiana. An enclosed chain, just like the Honda. Yeah, it looks like that was glued. You get your mouse trap. Forget which way this flips up. Not that way. Okay, two-stroke oil, gas. One of these sides is a little toolbox. They say it does 53 miles an hour. Let's find out.
Let's see, now we figured out that neutral is all the way back. So that first. So then they're second. And there's third. So second, first. Thank you. the tiny drum brakes stop adequately. I don't like holding it all the way open. I'm not. 40. All right, I could go more, but I don't like beating the piss out of my two strokes. I'd say 45 is tops. Clunky as hell transmission. I wonder if these clutches adjust. Maybe you should wait till the RPMs completely die. We're gonna turn left here. This is an interesting road that I don't take too often because it's dirt. That's third. Down into second. Get to pass the bicycle. Of course, I'm 205 pounds. That's gonna work the suspension. This is what unincorporated Florida looks like. Our unpaved roads are sand. It's amazing, this is right off Route 1, which before the interstate was major transportation. What we got here? Another dirt road. Canal Road. This is downtown Edgewater, folks. What gear am I in? There we go, first. Oh, so that's the canal. Don't look like much. I don't want to get back on one with this little thing. We're going to go down here. If I can't turn left, we're going to turn around. Okay, so you gotta shift a lot. Yeah, it's a clunky transmission. Was that the way I was supposed to go? Oh no, I'm lost. Well, it's just like I said. It's a tiddler. Make a nice pit bike, camp bike, something you can stow in your van easily, something to buzz around the swap meets for. Man, it's something a little different. Let's go home and say hi to Inga. She's probably freaking out. And we're back.